So this is the second part of this lecture, and that is Schrodinger time dependent wave equation. So in this lecture, in presentation part, we have discussed with discussed for the wave function psi, which is actually the function of x, y, z in t. That's why this is time dependent term is used here. And this wave function, the details, the properties of this wave function has been mentioned in that presentation. And this wave function psi is actually a complex quantity. So this is the complex quantity. That's why this is represented as equivalent to e a to the power minus I omega t minus kx. So if you want to compare this wave function psi with that ordinary wave term, wave function represented by a progressive wave is y, that is equivalent to e to the power omega t minus kx. So this additional term minus iota, that imaginary term, is introduced here to convert this y into psi. This is for the ordinary wave, and this is for this wave function psi to represent matter wave. So there is no individual physical significance of this. If you want to interpret physics, then we convert this as in terms of probability p. This is actually equal to, this is proportional to psi square, and this psi square is actually real. Why? Because this is equivalent to psi star multiplied by psi, where the psi is the complex conjugate of this wave function psi. So this is the real one, and if anyone has a simple knowledge of that complex quantity, this psi is if a complex quantity, then the psi square will be the real one. Like that, let's say we have this z is equivalent to a plus iota b, then this z star, this is equivalent to the complex conjugate will be a plus a minus iota b, and this multiplication of that z star, that's equivalent to a square plus b square, because this psi square, this is equal to minus 1. This is the property of complex number. So this psi square is the real quantity, which is, that's why this p is the probability of showing the position of any particle at particular position as well as at particular time, so per unit volume. So in order to derive this Schrodinger time dependent equation, first we convert this wave function psi in terms of energy and momentum. So the first step is, if you want to derive this Schrodinger equation, the first step is just step number one. We have to use this psi, it is equivalent to a exponential of minus I multiplied by e t minus omega t minus kx. This is in terms of frequency, and this k, that is the, where this omega, this is equivalent to 2 pi nu, and this k, this wave vector, that is equivalent to 2 pi by lambda. First condition is we have to convert this in terms of energy and momentum. So this is converted into that psi is equivalent to a exponential of minus I by h cross et minus px. How it is converted, just let me use some simple calculation. This energy, so first let me convert this omega into energy. This is omega, and energy e, it is equivalent to h nu from Planck's hypothesis, where this this nu, this is equal to h multiplied by 2 pi nu by 2 pi, just multiplying by 2 pi numerator with numerator and denominator, and this is h upon 2 pi, it is equivalent to h cross, and this 2 pi nu is equivalent to omega, where this h cross, this is another another Planck constant. This is h upon 2 pi, whose value is 1.05 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So if you want to replace this omega t, then this omega, it is equal to e upon h cross. This is one term, so omega can be replaced by e upon h cross. Second, we have this k is equal to 2 pi by lambda, so we have to convert this p into momentum, k into momentum p. Then we will use de Broglie's hypothesis that lambda, it is equal to h upon p, and this k it is equal to 2 pi by lambda. So this is equal to 2 pi p by h, and this can be written as equal to p upon h cross. So this is k, this is omega, and this is k. When we replace this omega by e upon h cross and k by p upon h cross, then simply we can convert this psi from omega k terms to energy and that momentum terms. And why we need that conversion, we will see later. So this is the simple conversion from one form to another form of this wave function. Now this is step number first. Now the step number second, we will use, so the calculation we will start from this second step. This psi, it is equal to exponential a multiplied by exponential of I upon h cross e t minus p x. We have to use this energy, conservation of energy for a free particle, since we know that the total energy, it is actually equal to its kinetic energy plus its potential energy. This kinetic energy in terms of momentum and mass, from 11th class physics, we will have p square by 2m plus this momentum, potential energy can be represented either by v or u. So here we are using u. So this energy E is equal to p square plus upon 2m plus u. This is the base for derivation of this Schrodinger time dependent equation. Now I will multiply this by that wave function psi. So E is equal to wave function psi, it is equal to p square by 2m, the wave function psi, plus u, the wave function psi. Here this this wave function psi is the function of position as well as the function of time, because we have to derive this time dependent Schrodinger equation. Now we have to replace this e psi and p square psi by using this equation number first. So first of all, we have to calculate e psi by using this p square by 2m psi by using this. So e psi, we can calculate e psi by differentiating this psi with respect to time, because the time parameter is here. And p square by 2m p square by 2m is here, so here only p is there, so we have to differentiate this by 2 times with respect to x. So in that presentation I have just mentioned that we are differentiating this with respect to time, just a single time, because we need this e only, and 2 times with respect to x, because we need here this p square by 2m. So now let us differentiate this psi square term with respect to time. So del psi by del t, it is equal to this exponent, we know this simple formula of our differentiation, this a exponential of I by h cross is the constant, and for this exponential that term is same, minus px, and then multiplied by this and this, because we have to differentiate with respect to time, so this parameter is taken as constant, so multiplied by I by h cross e. And this term can be further written as equivalent to psi. So one can write this is equal to minus I by h cross e psi. if you want to have this E psi separately, then one can write this E psi, it is equal to, just to convert here, this is minus H upon H cross by I del psi by del t, and this is, this can be further rationalized as just multiply iota denominator and numerator, one will have this H cross del psi by del t. So this is the term, this is equation number 3. Now let us differentiate this psi with respect to x two times. So the first time this is del psi by del x, it is equivalent to, again the same parameter will be a exponential of I by h cross, this will be as a, taken as constant et minus px, and this will be multiplied by minus, minus minus become plus, so this is plus iota p by h cross, and when, so again this is just to differentiate this by x again, so this is a exponential of I by h cross et minus px, and let me take the square of this, the first time, second time we will get the same parameters again, terms again, so the square of this and I square is minus, and one can convert this as a psi, so one will have, this is equivalent to minus p square by h cross square psi. So one can calculate p square psi from this equation number 4, and by substituting this e psi and p square psi, we can have that Schrodinger equation. So that Schrodinger equation term will be, now let us so we have this E psi, it is equal to H cross del psi by del t, and P square psi is equal to H cross square with minus sign, H cross square and del square psi by del x square. So these are two terms, and we have that equation from equation 2, we have this E psi is equivalent to P square psi by 2m plus u psi. So in one form, we simply substitute the value of this p square psi, and we will have this E psi is equal to minus h square by 2m del square psi by del x square plus u psi, and one will have this relation like this by substituting all this parameter in one side, that h square by 2m del square psi by del x square plus e minus u psi is equal to 0. In some books it is also written in terms of h square 2m, sorry, this is del square psi by del x square plus 2m by h square e minus u psi is equal to 0. So this is Schrodinger's time dependent equation in one form, where only that momentum term is replaced by that differential term, and if you want to replace this energy term also, then in the second form as mentioned in that presentation, is here this E psi is equivalent to H cross del psi by del t, it is equivalent to, this would be one iota term also, I H cross. So this is p square is, where that p square is this minus h square by 2m del square psi by del x square plus u psi. It is that Schrodinger's time dependent equation. So in these two forms, any one form can be used, can be written, and this is del square psi by del x square plus 2m by h square e minus u psi. Many books this form is given, and in some books, in especially that author B sir, this term is given. So this u, this is the function of position and the time. If you know this the value of this u, one can calculate that wave function for any position in any time and for any particular physical problem. Okay, thank you all.